provocative question. We all wonder in amazement that no matter what the testing scenario is, and whether it's a test match, you have this complete Captain Cool, you know, the tag that you've achieved. Are you really that cool? What goes through your head to be that cool?
To start off, I would say I have a bit of cough and cold, so I won't sound very nice, and I'll keep coughing. But the reality is, you know, I can't blame it on Delhi. Ki Delhi mein hawa kharab hai, that's why I'm having this cough and cold. I have it for the last few days, so nothing related to that. It's good to be here. It's a pleasure coming here. You know, kafi time ke baad main Delhi aa raha hu. And now to answer what you asked, I think I am as each and every individual is. We all feel the frustration. We all feel the irritation when things are not going our way. But what is important is, you know, does frustration lead to anything that is good for the team? You know, what at that point of time, what I am thinking is what needs to be done. You know, galti ho sakti hai kisi individual se hui ho ya puri team se hui ho ki jo bhi hamara plan tha, maybe we didn't execute our plans well. You know, whatever the format may be, T20 ho, test cricket ho, ya 50 over format ho. So I like to get into the process again. You know, what can be done right now, depending on the situation. Test match mein, you have two innings, so at times you get slightly longer duration to plan out your next move. One day mein thoda time constraint hota hai. T20 mein everything happens very quickly, so the demands are very different. But I would say that, you know, I feel equally frustrated. I also feel angry at times. I feel disappointed. But what is important is none of these are constructive. You know, what needs to be done right now is more important than any of these emotions. So when I get into the thinking of what needs to be done, abhi mujhe kya karna hai, what is the next thing that I can plan, who is the individual I can use. And once I get into it, you know, I'm controlling my emotions in a much better way. So I would say I'm like everyone else. It's just that I control my emotions slightly better than some of the other individuals, you know, because I feel, you know, human beings have a lot of emotions, and especially us Indians, you know, we thrive on emotions. So, you know, it will be wrong to say that, you know, these are something that doesn't come to my mind. Yes, you know, I also face each and everything, but I always felt that my emotions should be under my control. And if I'm able to do that, then my thinking will be more constructive, and also it will help me think more about the process than the result, because result can put undue pressure on the individual or as a team in the full.
Thank you, MS. That's what did you seek to achieve when you were pulling together the team? What in your mind makes a great winning team? And did you really think that when you went in to play that T20 the first time round, that you were going to emerge as world champions?
Ultimately, what you do is you break it into the smaller things. Something as small as, you know, particular, there was something very particular about that T20 World Cup. You know, bowl out was one of the things. And before that, we have never practiced bowl out. So what we did as a team was, whenever we went for practice, we said, to start the practice off, we'll have a bowl out. Whether it's before the warm-up or after the warm-up, because we may need, or there may come a situation where we may have to do a bowl-out session, you know, after a game if it's a tie. And we said, it's very clear, yes, it is for fun, but at the same time, whoever hits the wicket most number of times, they will be the ones who will be used if the situation arises. You know, it has nothing to do with, I'm a bowler, this is my job, I will do it. I was like, no. Again, it's like a performance thing. We'll keep doing it every day, and whoever has the best hit ratio will be the ones who will be used. And we started in that way, and we never realized actually that in the first few games itself, you know, against the Pakistan game, there'll be a bowl out session. So a lot of people ask me, you know, we used a lot of bowlers who were in the bowl out, who are not regular bowlers or who won't have been the first preference. And I was like, you know, we picked the ones who are best equipped or who practiced the best or who gave us the best result, because it was something that was very unusual for us. But we prepared in a way that we were ready for it. So similarly, throughout the T20 World Cup, it was very interesting that it was the first time the T20 World Cup was played. We had not played a lot of games before that. So we had a lot of challenges in front of us, you know, how to approach the game, you know, so we wanted to be more expressive on the field. And ultimately, you know, winning or losing, it comes to each and every individual who's part of the team. You know, everybody, when you play a team sport, everybody has a role and responsibility. And I felt throughout the T20 World Cup, the roles and responsibilities that were given to individuals, you know, it was fulfilled to the best manner possible. And that was the reason, you know, because of which we won the tournament. You know, it's not always about few of the individuals, you know, performing a lot better than the whole lot. You know, what you want is everybody to contribute. That one wicket at that right moment, a good run out, an outstanding catch. You know, these are the things that can really shift the momentum of the game. And we were able to do that. Whenever there was a tough scenario, we had an individual who rose up to the occasion and performed well for the team. So these were the things we are looking for. We are not looking at the result. Yes, we wanted to win the tournament, but we are not looking at the result. What we said was we'll take care of the small things. You know, I still remember almost from that South Africa game, you know, everything was like a knockout game. You know, and we, when we were playing against South Africa, it was one of the greenest wicket or most lively wicket, you know, one of the most lively that I'd seen in the shortest of format. But again, you know, few of the individuals, they batted well. We got just enough runs on the board, but then the bowlers took over and they in fact put so much pressure on the South African batsmen that they were not able to qualify. You know, if they would have won, they would have easily qualified. Then there was a scenario where they needed to score some 120 runs or something. Even if they lose, they would have qualified for the next stage. But ultimately, we bundled them up for something because of which they were not even able to get into the next stage. So I think, you know, as a team, we did very well. And I always felt whenever you're playing a team sport, your team needs to perform. Yes, there will be games where one individual or two individual will win you the game. But the moment it comes to winning a tournament, everybody needs to contribute and at a substantial level. So I felt, you know, T20 was that was a great tournament to start that off. And we were just more expressive on the field and we were better prepared to deal with different situations, you know, compared to some of the other teams.
Very interesting. MS, you know, one of the things that it takes many decades of hard work to achieve instant success. You know, the world sees the success part and the journey that you've gone on, and why I mentioned the MS Dhoni, the untold story, the inspiration story that, you know, has been told on celluloid. One of the questions that I have for you is, and now this is taking away from cricket, but I really want to focus on, what are those ingredients? And as you grew up as a child, you know, what drove in you that tenacity, that determination, that mental strength, that irrespective of what the odds are, irrespective of what the disappointments were, that you were able to keep that North Star in front of you and your goals, and therefore be able to strive to excel to that. I feel that, you know, while you've had an extremely illustrious cricketing career where the whole world writes and talks about, to me this is another part of your life and story which I feel, with a young country like India and frankly someone like me who's got a young child, is an equally, empowering story. So tell a little bit about that. You know, what was that like, and what prepared you for this big league that you arrived in?
You know, your question seems very technical, but the thing is, I always felt the answer that I'll give, it's a very simple answer, and you know, a lot of times you think it's very complex when it comes to the kind of cricketing career I had. It all boils down to the simplest of things. Like when I started cricket, it was for fun. You know, I used to play tennis ball cricket. It was mostly for fun. You know, every day you go, you compete, you learn, you come back. Next day again, 4 o'clock, you go. And if you have lost the other day, you want to win that next day. You know, so it all started from there. And then finally, you know, cricket started in school where I must be like 13, 14 at that point of time. And we used to have summer camp during the summer vacation. So that was my first exposure to leather ball cricket. You know, it always feels nice because all of a sudden you get access to wicket keeping pads or batting pads, you get leather balls, gloves, bat, helmet, everything. And there's a whole process, you know, you carry your mat from the hall to the ground and you stick the mat, you get it ready to play, then you play, practice, bowl, bat, whatever, and then, you know, follow the same process, keep it back. So it's all very interesting compared to tennis ball cricket, where you turn up, you put the wickets, you have a ball, bat, and you start playing. And after that, I played a lot of other sport. But that exposure during that summer vacation, you know, actually got me closer to proper leather ball cricket. And after that, I started practicing slightly more, spent a bit more time with the school team. And after 1 year, you know, I started playing for my school team. So for me, it all started with one. And one of the most crucial things throughout was being honest to myself. You know, I never thought that I'll play for the country. Coming from Ranchi, which was part of Bihar at that point of time, you know, it was not like when you're playing and you look up and you're like, no, I want to play for the Indian cricket team. So it all started as if I wanted to have fun, I wanted to play for my school team. Then I started playing for the school team. What is next? The next became the under 16 district team. Once you play for the district, then state is the next team. So slowly and gradually, you start taking care of the small term goals. You know, because it's always more interesting, it's in front of you, and you start doing the small things right, you actually see yourself accomplishing those goals, and ultimately you keep tweaking your targets. So from the district, it becomes the state, from state, it becomes zone. Finally, 2000 was the big year where Bihar was hosting the under 19 India level tournament where all the states come and they compete, and we were able to reach the finals of that tournament, and because of the performance in the tournament, I got a chance to play for the Ranji Trophy team. So that proper professional cricket started from 2000. And then also we play a sport that involves a bit of luck also. You know, we can't deny that fact, because I always found cricket to be a great leveler in life. You know, and somehow I always talk about it like how it is very interesting. You know, you start the game with a flip of a coin. You know, you don't know which way it will fall. Then you don't know who will, like if you're an opener, you know, okay, I'll go and play the new ball and they'll be playing their best fast bowlers. But after that, there's no surety to anything. You know, the number three batsman can bat in the second over, or he can bat in the 25th over, or there's an X factor involved to it. But again, going back to, you know, how it all matured for me was, I got lucky, I passed out from school, I got a job with the railways. Now, coming from a middle class background, one of the things your parents are always worried about is your future. And, you know, sports never had a, I would say it never had a great future at that point of time. A lot of parents would be worried, acha cricket khel raha, I don't know future mein kya hoga. But the moment I got my job with the railways, you know, my parents were quite relaxed as to, you know, whatever he does from now on, he has something to fall back to. You know, if he's not successful in life, he'll fall back to, you know, with work when it comes to the railways, and he'll have a future, you know, whatever that future may be. So I feel all these small things which fall into places which may or may not be in your control also contribute a lot. But the most important ingredient, yes, hard work is there, dedication is there, passion is there, but I felt being honest is one of the most important things. To start off being honest to yourself. Unless you are honest to yourself, you can't be honest to others. And what it also does is, it helps you in accepting what the shortcomings are. You may not be a great player, you know, may not be a great human being, but if you're willing to accept the shortcomings, you can always look to improve. You can go to people, you can ask for help, and there'll be people to guide you out. You know, whether it's your seniors, whether it's your parents, close friends, whoever those may be. And I always felt all these things really helped me keep moving ahead in life. You know, throughout being honest towards the goal. What is the goal? The goal is not to, for me it was never to score so many runs for India. For me it was always, you know, how we'll be able to win a game. Whether you are the captain or you're not the captain. What you want is, you know, how much you have contributed for the team to win. Then if you become a senior player in the team, or if you're the captain in the team, your main thing then becomes, apart from the team success, is what you're really doing to make it comfortable for others to perform. You know, all of us, we perform as individuals, but what you want is what we are doing so that others are performing, whether we are giving them enough time, whether they are grooming them, whether we are putting them in the right direction as seniors, you know, where they are also able to perform. So I would say I always felt I had a very simple life. You know, it was very simple when it came to the journey. I would always take care of the things that were in my control. I was never bothered about selection. If I didn't get selected, for me it was like I need to score more runs, I need to do better wicket keeping, because those are the things that will help me perform. You know, thinking about not getting selected won't help me in any ways. You know, it won't really help me get better. You know, it will only fill me with more bitterness, and you know, I'll have to work hard even more to get into the team. So ultimately you have to keep adapting yourself. So how quick are you when it comes to that adaptation thing is something that also defines, you know, how successful you'll be in the future. So if I have to sum it up, yes, dedication, hard work, passion, all of it is there, but you have to be honest to the core. If you're not honest, then you know, a lot of times you may complicate things. So I always thought, you know, being honest was one of the key factors that really helped me be where I am right now.
Oh, excellent. That's really great. To talk to you, your sincerity and humility and your honesty in the conversation is.
I have bahut dino ke baad.
Praveen ji. Ab Praveen ji ko jante
hain? Main news ke through jaata.
I'll go on that side, yeah. We'll just hold that. Hopefully he will accept to go digital, yeah.
हाँ तो
क्या हाल चाल है आपका?
बस फर्स्ट क्लास. आप कैसे हैं?
बस मैं भी बढ़िया हूँ.
तो हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं और प्रॉब्लम है ना, बहुत लोग सुन रहे हैं यहाँ पे बैठ के, जो कि जनरली फोन कॉल्स में होता नहीं है. बट ये एक स्पेशल कॉल है मास्टर कार्ड के तरफ से. तो उन्होंने बोला कि मैं रांची में किसी ऐसे शॉप से बात करूँ ना जहाँ पे मैं भी जाता था और मैंने भी काफ़ी चीज़ें खरीदी हूँ. तो मैंने बोला कि मैं भाटिया स्टोर्स बहुत जाता था क्योंकि स्पोर्ट्स से था और भाटिया स्टोर्स में बेस्ट शटल कॉक्स मिलते थे जब हम लोग बैडमिंटन खेलते थे. मुझे नहीं पता उस समय आप शॉप में थे या नहीं थे. तो जब हमारे पास ज़्यादा पैसे होते थे तो हम लोग डटसन खरीदते थे, जब कम पैसे होते थे तो विकी का कॉर्क खरीदते थे. तो और बिजनेस कैसा चल रहा है आपका?
बस ठीक ठाक चल रहा है, बढ़िया चल रहा है.
रांची में तो मुझे मौका मिल नहीं पाता है.
और आजकल तो आपका आना काफी कम हो गया है.
हाँ,
लेकिन आपकी माता जी तो आती रहती हैं.
हाँ, मम्मी रेगुलर आती है.
हाँ, तो आपके बारे में पता चलता रहता है.
हाँ, और इनफैक्ट जहाँ पे आपका दुकान है वहाँ पे आएंगे तो प्रॉब्लम ज्यादा होगी, सोल्यूशन कम होंगे.
जी जी सही बात है.
हाँ,
भीड़ भाड़ वाला इलाका है, सही बात है.
तो हमारी तरफ से रिक्वेस्ट था कि हम अभी एक नई टीम हमने बनाई है, टीम कैशलेस इंडिया, जिसमें हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि जो भी हमारे जो नेबरिंग एरिया है, जो कि जो भी हमारे घर मोहल्लों के आसपास जो शॉप्स वगैरह हैं, दुकानें हैं, उनको भी हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं डिजिटल बनाने की. तो एक रिक्वेस्ट हमारे तरफ से ये है कि हम चाहते हैं, क्योंकि आपका लोकेशन इतना इम्पोर्टेंट है और आपके आसपास इतने सारे जो फ्लैट्स हैं और घर हैं, तो हम चाहते हैं कि आप भी डिजिटल जाएं और जो डिजिटल पेमेंट है वो आप भी एक्सेप्ट करना स्टार्ट करें, यू नो, उस लोकेलिटी में.
जी जी सर.
तो आपका कमिटमेंट है, आप भी करेंगे?
एकदम वादा रहा आपसे, नेक्स्ट टाइम जब आप रांची आओगे तो आप खुद देखोगे कि मैं डिजिटल पेमेंट ही ले रहा हूँ।
नहीं तो ये बहुत अच्छी बात है, और मुझे अपनी मम्मी को भी कन्विंस करना होगा, क्योंकि मेरी मम्मी भी अभी थोड़ी कैश वाली ही है, यू नो। तो मैं बाहर वालों को तो रिक्वेस्ट कर ही रहा हूँ, घर वालों को भी बताना पड़ेगा कि थोड़ा कार्ड सिस्टम पे आना पड़ेगा, यू नो। और
सही बात,
मैं तो खैर बहुत पहले से ही कार्ड से ऑपरेट करने लगा हूँ, बट बहुत ही अच्छा लगा आपका इंक्लिनेशन, और आपने जिस तरीके से बोला कि नेक्स्ट टाइम जब मैं आऊँगा तो आप भी डिजिटल पेमेंट एक्सेप्ट करेंगे। और मैं यही बोलना चाहूँगा कि मैं डेफिनेटली आऊँगा, कुछ ना कुछ खरीदने आऊँगा, और दिवाली के बाद आऊँगा। तब तक मैं यही रिक्वेस्ट करूँगा कि आप डिजिटल पेमेंट्स लें, बिकॉज डिजिटल नहीं होगा तो मैं आपको पेमेंट नहीं करूँगा, फिर फ्री में सामान लेके जाऊँगा।
सही बात है। ये वादा रहा मेरा कि आपसे कि जब भी आप आओगे दुकान में डिजिटल पेमेंट शुरू होगा।
चलिए बहुत बढ़िया, इट्स अ गुड स्टार्ट। फिर मैं रांची आके आपसे मिलता हूँ।
ठीक है।